So if we can begin by looking back at last Saturday's game against Gateshead, obviously it's a game that ideally you take 3 points for, but if not, very important not to lose the game. Is that how you see it?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, of course, we'd rather have come back with the 3 points, but the way the game went, we was 1-0 down and we had a little bit of pressure on us. We had a couple of our own chances, but it was important to come back with at least a point. It keeps Gateshead within our reach, and with 9 games to go, it's better to be where we are than another 3 points if we'd have lost away from them. So it was not the best result we wanted, but it was certainly the second best.
You had a few players that had been called into action just after injury. I'm thinking about people like Asa Hall and Dean Mox, and they all played their part in getting that result. So you must have been happy with the fighting spirit that your team showed, because after scoring early on in the second half, it would have been very easy to wilt in those conditions.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think for a few games now we've had a wilting team. I think, you know, they've really worked hard, fought for the cause, if you like. I'm not saying everyone's been brilliant over the last few games, but we've certainly been trying to be competitive and not give up. Excuse me. There's not any of the boys that I could point at and say, you're not trying, because to be fair, A, they wouldn't be on the pitch, and B, they wouldn't play again, sort of thing. So the boys are still up for it. It's a good dressing room, a very good dressing room. And we still believe that there's opportunities to get out of the trouble that we're in, or, as Downsy says, get out of the drama that we're in.
One player that came into the starting up was Jack Stobbs, who made his debut, and he obviously played an influential part in the goal. How did you assess his performance?
I thought he did well. He was only training with us a day. We could see what he's got. You know, he played a big part in the goal, where, you know, he went past a couple of people like they weren't there, and hit a good cross, and it got deflected slightly to Kieran, and he struck it well. Like, he should have struck the one in the first 5 minutes. That was a good chance, but he struck it well, and it was good to get that goal at that time. So, but I was pleased with his performance, and watching him in training this week, he's got more, and I'm really, really pleased with that signing. Really pleased.
Another son he must have been absolutely delighted with. He was getting rave reviews from both sets of fans during the game, is Nico Lawrence. It's so easy to forget sometimes that he's only 19 years of age.
Yeah, he had a very, very strong strong game. They put us under quite a bit of pressure, and he came out of it with Ross as well, and the back four. They had to defend stoutly, and they did. They defended together, and we blocked. I think it said in the papers that they had 20 shots. Well, only 4 or 5 got through to the goalkeeper. The rest were blocked, and they class that as a shot on target often. So, and if you're blocking shots, then you know you've still got that spirit to keep you in the game when an opposition are in your final third, as it were, or in your penalty area. And our team do throw themselves at things when they need to, and that's what we're going to need for sure. But, you know, Nico is going to be a top player, and it's nice to have been involved in his career, and hopefully if we can sneak out of it, get out of this situation, then he would have had a great experience. And Southampton are very happy with what we're doing for him, and we're very happy with what he's doing for us.
So looking ahead to this weekend then, Gaffer, it's home game against Dagenham Redbridge, a team that on the fringes of those chasing for the playoffs. Approach this game any differently at all from a team that's down near where we are at the bottom of the table?
No, we got to approach it in a tactical way like we always do. You hope that the players perform on the day. Dagenham have got, there's a lot of different scenarios. Dagenham have got a new manager, he's only had one game. He knows the club well because he used to play for him, Ben Stevens, and he knows this league well. We're on the last, as we speak, the last day that you can have sign-ins, so you never know what might crop up a bit later on this afternoon as lastminute.com sign-ins. So yeah, we'll have to wait and see what they may bring in, but we know they're a good team. They've lost a couple of players, they've gained a couple of players, and we'll have to see what team turns up. However, it's about us. It really has got to be about us, and you know, we've got to make sure that our fans enjoy the performance. And if they enjoy the performance, there's a fair chance that we won the game. And that's been our whole focus all season. But you know, certainly you want to entertain as well as win games. And I know we say that every week. Oppositions don't allow you to do that sometimes, but you've got to rise above it and hope that you get that early goal, or you get that little bit of luck, or you know that gets you a result. Because any result now for any of the teams that are down in the bottom six or seven is a big result.
It's vitally important to remember that point you just said there, Gaffer. It is just about us, because the highlight of most recently is that win against Barnet, a team that's up in the playoffs in and around there going for promotion, and
yeah,
your team produced a marvellous performance that day too.
Yeah, it's true. There was a few good results against some of the top teams. We got a couple of big games against teams that are in and around us. Gateshead obviously was one. We've got Scunthorpe, we've got York, you know, we've got they're all six pointers if you can get them, and the boys know that. You know, we often have meetings and we let them have their say and we have our say, and I just know that we're going into the last nine games without any negatives, if you like. You know, that's important, that is. And I know that the dressing room is strong, because there's some good leaders in there, and you know, none of us want to have an unsuccessful season. We want to keep going and get us out of this little bit we're in.